You want to make sure that you have set yourself up for a long-term plan, right? You don't want to suddenly find yourself getting deactivated over a stupid false rider report. You could have 15,000 trips. You could be a 5.0 driver and suddenly you're off the system. So you got to set yourself up. If that does happen, you have plan B in place long-term. Right, in this formula, I've literally taught thousands of drivers over the years. And that is, every single time you have someone on board in the car with you and you hit it off, you guys get on so well. Could be a guy, could be a girl, could be a family, but you just feel like you have a connection and you're talking from the beginning right to the point you're dropping them off at the airport. And you say, hey, thank you so much. I really enjoyed the conversation. Five-star passenger, thank you. And by the way, here's my business card. If you ever get stuck somewhere, right, call me. I also do private trips. But only to those riders where you just have a connection. You guys get on well. Don't risk handing out your cards to people where they are a question mark or they're an unknown. You just don't have a great conversation with them in the car, right? And also make sure that you have your business card attached to all of the magazines in your car, right? Why am I telling you this? Because you could think, well, you know, handing out business cards, recruiting people through the platform, you'll get deactivated. If you do it the right way, you will never, ever get deactivated. And it's called a soft sale. You never do a hard sale on an individual. Oh, by the way, here's my card, right? Again, only those people you have an amazing connection with, right? And the conversation is flowing and you're on the same page. And you just feel like that 1 hour trip went like that because you had so much to share. Those are the type of people that's sort of special connection. You want to keep that connection going on forever. In form of a private client, which means you might be paying a little bit of extra money to get your private chauffeur license or your livery license. But what you are doing is you are constantly recruiting from your pool of Uber and Lyft riders, passengers, and you're bringing them across into your private company for long-term 100% benefits, right? Because you know that right now the split is as bad as 75% in some places for Uber and Lyft and 25% for you. Once upon a time, 6 years ago, it was the other way around. You were getting 75, they were getting 25. You cannot survive on 25% of the cut and face a possible deactivation down the line. So you have to take care of yourself. I preach this every single week. Do not be shy to spend a little bit of money on your private chauffeur, on your livery license. Go out there, spend the $700-$800, get yourself an LLC. Make sure you have the right car. Maybe you're an SUV or a minivan, something in the form of XL, and then start recruiting like crazy, right? But only recruit those passengers that you have an amazing connection with, because then it's an automatic sale. By the way, that was an amazing trip. Thank you for sharing. I hope we reconnect sometime. Here's my card. And by the way, that's my vehicle, so you won't forget me. I drove you in this car, and that's me there. So if you have those two factors on your business card, you've set yourself up for long-term success. And anyone that has followed that formula, right? Ask Thomas Gibson, ask Paul Figueroa, ask all of those individuals who are on the Uber and Lyft platform, but are taking care of their private business, because the day could come that they cut you off. And never, ever say never. No, it's not going to happen to me, right? Out of the blue, the top drivers have been deactivated for no reason. And you want your backup plan. You want to make sure that you have recruited 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, in my case, over 100 private clients. Where did I get them all from? I got them from the pool of Uber and Lyft clients that got into my Lux vehicle or into my SUV or into my XL. I would advise you not to recruit Uber X clients, right? Make sure you go out there and get a specific type of caliber, high paying passenger that you can service long term. Could be a CEO, could be an NBA player, could be an actor, could be a wealthy family, right? Could be a family whose kids you're going to be driving a lot, right? But those type of clients will book you over and over and over again, because for them it boils down to two things: the right price, and more importantly, safety. I can trust this individual. I can trust this individual with my kids. I like his or her driving style, and you will be with them forever. And other magic things will come about, right? I could tell you, I could write a book of the special type of relationships I have built up with private clients who are now friends. And I get all of these extended benefits from these individuals that all started out in an Uber and a Lyft vehicle. So if you want more input, if you want more advice, if you want some coaching on that, how to do it, number one, you got to get yourself a nice clean business card. This one's a little bit wrinkled, but with your face on there, right? It's got your face on there and it has your vehicle on there. So you can tell them, by the way, that's me on the card. That's the car I drove you. And they'll never forget you. They'll never, ever forget you. Have your email on there. Have your text number. Tell them if you ever need to go to an airport, if your kids need to go to Disneyland or Universal, I'll be there. If you have anybody flying in from overseas, friends from Europe, I'll be there. Here's my card. But again, only those individuals, those Uber or Lyft riders that you get on so well with. And you know exactly what I'm talking about, right? In a full day, in a 6 or 8 hour driving session, you'll probably encounter that individual 4 to 5 times daily, right? That person that you hit it off with. Those are the people worthy of your card. Those are the people that you'll always want in your vehicle long term. Have a great day, and a huge shout out to my sponsor, LegalRideshare.com. If you or your passengers ever get into an accident, that should be the first address you call, LegalRideshare.com. They are in all 50 states and they do care about the drivers. They have a great Facebook page with a lot of good legal advice. I would go and like and subscribe to that. They also have a great YouTube channel, and Brian Greening, their lead attorney, cares about drivers. So that's my shout out to my wonderful sponsor, LegalRideshare.com. Drive safe, my friends.